Back in the days, India only had one real adventure bike, which was the Hero Impulse. Over the years, people started craving for more budget-friendly adventure bikes. Royal Enfield brought out the Himalayan and KTM got the Adventure 390. We also have the Xpulse 200, but there's a void in the market between the Xpulse 200 and the Royal Enfield Himalayan, and this gap needed to be filled.
KTM's most desirable offering today in our country is the Duke 250. In fact, it's so desirable that it's got many different avatars like the Husqvarna Swartwillen and the Witwillen 250, and also as the Dominar 250. And that was not about it. KTM decided to put one more 250cc motorcycle in the stables, and this time it gets the adventure treatment. Today we have this, the KTM Adventure 250. So design wise, the Adventure 250 looks very similar to the Adventure 390. It gets the revised body work, more plastics everywhere, but it's also more comfortable. You get a bigger seat than the Duke 250, and also you get a bigger tank at 14.5 liters. That's 1 liter more than a stock Duke 250. And also you get the same old headlights, like the BS6 Duke 250s get the similar units from the Duke 390 and the Adventure 390 lineup. So I think they've done that to, so it's easier to differentiate between an Adventure 250 and an Adventure 390, because if you look them from afar, they'll look the same, because it also has a new instrument cluster. At first it looks like the LED digital instrument cluster, but it's the LCD cluster, so it gives all the necessary information. It's quite well detailed and easy to read, but otherwise the knuckle guards are stock from factory, which is a good thing. Also they have nicely tucked in the radiators, so again it has two small fans on both the sides. So what the overall design has done is it also helped to keep the engine cooler. Well, the Duke 250 didn't have much issues with the engine heating, but they have just made it better over here. So, quick look at the specs. It gets the same 250cc motor with 30 bhp and 24 Nm of torque. It gets the same front suspension units from the Adventure 390, that's WP Apex. But we don't know if it's in the same tune as the Adventure 390, so that we still need to find out. And also the wheels are better than the stock Duke 250s. So just like the Adventure 390s, these can take quite a lot of bashing. And again, the brake rotors are the same, 320 mm and I think 240, 250 mm on the rear. So they are the same throughout the BS6 lineups of the 390s and the 250s. So you can expect really good braking performance on these bikes. And well, again, we have right here is one of the black paint schemes of the Adventure 250. You'll see the riding shorts, that's on the another color option of the Adventure 250. So on to the riding shorts.
I like how KTM have given all the necessary stuff to the Adventure 250. Like you get an adjustable windshield, you get knuckle guards, and also because the chassis and the body panels are similar to the Adventure 390, all the extra additional options and power parts which are available on the 390 are also available on the 250. So that just increases the options to customize your ride, even if you're going for off-road or long distance rides.
So post ride, this bike does put a smile in your face. I personally love the Duke 250's motor. It's the sweet spot between the Duke 200 and the Duke 390. It handles well, you have all the power in the mid-range, and well, when it gets the adventure avatar, it gets crazier. You can basically glide through the rough patches and the speed breakers or bumps, whatever our Indian roads throw at you. And well, handling wise, again, it's the same motor, but in a different state of tune. So the power is a little bit lax at the lower RPMs, but once you go up the RPMs, you get the power, and well, it's a really punchy bike to ride. In the city, it might be a little bit more comfortable than the Adventure 390, considering how well you have to shift in the gears, but not as much as the Adventure 390. So it's a really good bike to ride. Again, the seat is quite roomy, but it's on the stiffer side. Same thing with the suspension, but again, like I've said in the Adventure 390 and the Himalayan comparison video, that it's more of a rough roader than a hardcore off-roader, you know. So it can go anywhere, point A to point B, quick, and well, it can take quite a bashing also.
The Adventure 250 gets the exact same suspension components, braking components, and chassis from the Adventure 390. Also, this bike is missing out on major amount of electronics like the traction control, cornering, ABS, and a bi-directional quick shifter. But personally speaking, I don't think you need all that on this bike. The only thing which you need, and KTM have given, is the option to switch off the ABS in the rear in the off-road mode, so it's easier to lock that rear tire and go into slides and enjoy the bike as it is.
So a final verdict on the bike. Well, priced at 2.5 lakh rupee ex showroom, it's 50,000 rupees cheaper than the Adventure 390. So when you look at it, you pay 50,000 rupees more, you get a bi-directional quick shifter, cornering, ABS and traction control, and that lovely color instrument cluster. So people would say you need those, let's say, luxuries on this bike. No, you don't. It's quite a handler. You have the basic option to switch the rear ABS off. That's more than enough. It handles well, the brakes are amped, and if you seriously think you need a traction control and, let's say, cornering ABS on this bike, grow some balls. So let's not compare it to the Adventure 390, where it stands in the market today. So the nearest competitors are the Royal Enfield Himalayan and the X-Pulse 200. So the X-Pulse 200, it handles well, but it lacks that oomph when you hit the highways. And the Himalayan, well, it is a very comfortable bike. It's a really good bike off-road, but then again, you want to be quick and you don't want that weight on you. So this bike fits right in between both of them. You have 30 horsepower, you have 25 newton meters of torque, which is more than enough, and well, it can go anywhere. And the best part here is all the accessories which go on the body, let's say the saddlebag stays, etc., you can put them on the 250 as well, because they have a similar body structure. So again, if you want to customize it for touring, you have a lot of options. So should you go for it if you're looking for a, let's say you just want to get into touring and off-road altogether, well, it's definitely a big yes. So let me know down in the comments below, how do you think the Adventure 250 would be like? Would you consider purchasing one? Do check out our website and our Instagram, The Driver's Hub. We keep on posting updates and everyday automobile news over there. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.